It is the 16th day of April 2017. A good Sunday afternoon to you from wherever you are watching us. This is Weekend at One. My name is Michelle Ngele. We have all the top stories making headlines at this hour. We do have our political reporter Chris Thairu live in Narok, where an aspirant for the parliamentary seat in Kiambu County who had been abducted was later found. Chris, what do you expect from your end?
Well, I can confirm that the aspirant, that is Charles Chege, has just been taken to Gakan Hospital in Nairobi from Narok, where he was found, Michelle.
All right, well, Chris Thairu will be giving us more details on that. But first, let's take a look at other news making headlines. Missing Kabete parliamentary seat aspirant Charles Chege found alive but unconscious in Narok County. 3 MPs from Kakamega, Toboso, Otalu and Lisa Mula losing ODM nominations conducted yesterday.
We must try to keep the peace. We must try to keep the peace. Let us not incite war to Kupigana.
And Bomet Governor Isaac Ruto asks NCIC to take action against politicians engaging in hate speech and violence. Welcome to the program. The missing Kabete parliamentary aspirant Charles Chege, popularly known as Fresh, has been found alive in Narok County. Chege, who went missing from Friday, was found unconscious and has been rushed to the Narok District Hospital for tests and treatment. Chege, who is popularly known as Fresh, was allegedly dumped by his kidnappers after drugging him. According to Narok OCPD Philip Kipkirui, police have launched investigations into the incident that sparked protests by Kabete residents. Let's now listen in to what the OCPD had to say this morning.
They took him into their vehicle, where after taking some distance, they ordered him to take some soda, which were containing some drugs. And they took him to a known house where they kept him almost the whole night. During the night, he was given some bread and soda. Later on, he found himself at Narok, where he can't recall where it was. After gaining some sense, he walked up to Ash Petrol Station, where he found a taxi driver by the name Samson Odiambo. He introduced himself to that driver, and that driver, took him to Narok Hospital, where he is now, and he has been given some medication and he's out of danger. He was not injured, only during when he was being transported in that vehicle, those culprits stepped on his ribs and he was feeling some pains. But he's out of danger, he was not shot. There is no physical injuries caused on him.
Yes. And maybe according to him, can he recall where he was when he was being given bread and stuff? And what time was that?
He can only recall that he was given some drugs while in that vehicle. The second drugs which were given to him was yesterday night around 10:00 p.m. He was given another drug whereby he became unconscious up to this morning, 6 in the morning, when he gained his consciousness at Narok.
So where exactly in Narok was he from?
He can't know. Only he found himself near Ash Petrol Station, where he found that that taxi driver.
Have you talked to the taxi driver, and what time was that?
He said he found him at 6:30 a.m. And we are now preparing to escort him up to Aga Khan Hospital for further treatment. And then the Kabete people will officers will take over the case.
Okay.
Yes.
You've also said that you're waiting.
Hello, Chris Thayer is live for us from Narok. Chris, quite a bizarre incident, the kidnapping of Charles Chege. What more can you tell us about the events that ensued since his kidnapping?
Well, Michelle, I can confirm that Charles Chege, a.k.a. Chege Fresh, who is the aspirant for the Kabete parliamentary seat, has just been discharged from Narok District Hospital. And he was admitted here at around 6:30 after he was found in Narok town at around 6 in the morning. And just to give us a brief on the events on how they unfolded, is the taxi driver who brought him to hospital, and actually he'll be telling us first by telling us your name and then tell us the ordeal that happened in the morning.
Asante sana. Mimi naitwa Samson Odhiambo na niliondoka kwangu saa 11 na nusu nikaketi hadi risali moja kaenda. Baadaye nikaona mtu anakuja kitambaa akiwa amevaa trouser nyeusi, viatu nyeusi, shati ya Jubilee, lakini dalili ni ya ulevi. Mpaka dakika moja nikaona driver mwenzangu akimfukuza asitaki maneno ulevi ulevi. Nilinyamaza kama mzee kidogo kwa sababu pengine wanaita mzee barubaru. Nikaamua nisikize mwenzangu wako na shida gani. Yes.
Kisha?
Basi nikanyamaza, nikarakisha kidogo, nikamuuliza maswali zake. Nikaona ni mtu ambaye alikuwa amevamiwa na watu fulani. Akanieleza nilipatiwa madawa mara mbili na baadaye nikakosa fahamu, sikujua naenda wapi. Wewe ndio umenisaidia ukinionyesha hati hapa ni Narok. Akanipatia namba, hii namba amenipea, tukaongea na yule ambaye alikuwa anampigia, kumbe ni mke wake na mimi sikuelewa. Baadaye nikapata fahamu nipatana na watu yake. Bas watu yake tukajaribu kuwasiliana mpaka tukafikia mimi nilifanya uamuzi badala ya kununua chai na mtu alipewa dawa nimpeleke hospitali kwanza. Juu nikimpatia chai akifa itasemekana ni mimi.
Lakini ulijuaje ni madawa amepewa na wala si ulevi kama ulikuwa umedhani hapo awali?
Nilidhani hivyo, lakini wakati niliongea na yeye alinipasha ya kwamba alitekwa nyara kutoka Kabete. Sasa nikasema huyu nisimpe chai hata kama tetemeka nifike paka Narok District Hospital.
Na alikuambia nani aliweza kumleta hapa Narok na aliletwa na gari ipi? Yeye mwenyewe alikuwa na hiyo fahamu kweli?
Hakufafanua kwa sababu hakuwa na fahamu juu vile kama alipewa madawa. Yeye alinieleza tu lugha moja, ati aliingishwa kwa gari upande wa nyuma, lakini kuna wajamaa walimkalia kiti nyuma. So Kenya nasikia kama vile siki mzuri, alinililia upande wa mbafu wa nini, lakini tukiangalia hakufunjika mbafu, ni uchovu tu kwa sababu alikuwa amekaliwa kama mzigo. Yes.
Well, asante sana. Well, Michelle, that is the taxi driver who actually brought Charles Chege to Narok District Hospital. Of course, so many questions that are still not answered. And of course, investigations, of course, will be expecting that they will be coming out with these with the answers of different questions. For instance, if at all these abductors had an interest of harming Chege, then why release him? Why spray his vehicle with bullets and then dump him in Narok town unharmed? Because as we speak for now, he is unharmed and he's out of danger. And so for now, I'm joined by Torome Kapaya, who is an aspirant of Narok East Constituency, just to tell us his fate about the aspirants. Well, he's an aspirant, Chege, for Jubilee party ticket. As an aspirant, do you feel threatened or are you safe or what's your assurance?
Well, for me, it's mixed reaction because we are not sure what is happening. Mine is only to request the government to give us security to ensure that all the aspirants are secured, because this incident is an incident that can bring panic and can also affect our politics. So mine is to ask especially the government to give us security and also ask our fellow aspirants also to beef up their own security.
You are the first aspirant to arrive here and of course visited the Mheshimiwa at his bed. Maybe what did he tell you? Because at least you had a chance to talk to him.
Yes, I visited him in his hospital bed. He told me that he was abducted and was given some congregation, some drugs that he could not even tell. And he told me how he got out of that, but he's out of danger. I saw him and he's all right. He has gone to Nairobi for further investigation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Thanks a lot. And we hope that maybe the government will take action in terms of security for the aspirants.
That's my hope. And I also hope that we'll finish our nomination without any other incident like this.
Okay, thank you. Of course, we know that the Jubilee Party is expecting to hold its party primaries on Friday. That is on the 21st of this month. And still so many questions, Michelle, but what we expect is that the government and, of course, the security apparatus in the country will, of course, start investigating these issues. Remember that it's not the first time that we're seeing a politician being abducted and later being dumped somewhere and found alive. Of course, so many questions, but all these will be leaving to the investigators to tell us what really transpired. Michelle.
Reese, of course, yesterday the ODM primaries kicked off in Narok County. What can you tell us with regard to the results coming in, but also the state of investigations as to the seven who are arrested over allegations of ballot stuffing as well?
Well, Michelle, the investigations regarding the seven gentlemen who were arrested yesterday in Kilgore's constituency during the ODM primaries are still ongoing. We are yet to talk to the police, but what we understand is that they are still investigating as to how those seven gentlemen were found with ballot boxes touched with ballot papers. And, of course, yesterday, coming in the morning, today, actually in the morning, that's when results were released at El Mashariani Primary School, which is one of the polling centers in Narok North constituency. And I can confirm that Rebecca Tonkei won that ticket, ODM ticket, by flowing or by defeating, that is Eunice Marima. And Rebecca Tonkei managed to garner 45,200 votes against her competitor, that is Eunice Marima, who managed to get 5,000 votes. When you come to the position of the senatorial seat, we had Ledama Olekina took that ticket, and he managed to garner 45,500 votes against his competitor, Tom Maitai. But Maitai is still claiming that yesterday's exercise was marred by irregularities, and actually accusing Ledama Olekina of working closely with party officials to infiltrate the results. But he has already launched his complaints to the National Elections Board of the party, and we'll be waiting for the National Elections Board of the party to tell us the next step. But of course, we know that the party primaries for ODM will still be ongoing even as we come to this week, because we know that on Tuesday, party primaries will be held in Nyamira, NKC County. Michelle.
All right. Thank you, Chris Thyre, there live for us from Narok County, keeping an eye, of course, on the ODM primaries that took place yesterday in Narok County. You're watching A Weekend at One. We take a short break now, but when we come back, we'll give you details on the results of the ODM nominations in Kakamega and Samburu counties. Don't go too far.